For this tutorial, I imported a gun model which I will use. I will also copy one of these default guns for this pack to the workspace. You need to copy the configuration and weapon type values from one of these built-in guns first. I will start with putting all these parts of this tool to a model. Keep in mind that handle part should not be in this model object. Next, we need to pick a primary part for this model. Just select a part from this model. The name you give it to it is not important, but you will need to put some instances inside this object. I will rename it, so it will look different than other meshes. For this next step, find the gun you copied to the workspace, or just pick one of these default guns, and then copy all stuff from its primary part. You can leave the weld constraint, since it's only for that specific model. As you can see, we have some attachments which we need to set. Switching to the other model, you can see how they are positioned. I will go over these attachments by highlighting them. They already have pretty explanative names right now other than these muzzle flash attachments. So muzzle flash attachments are pretty much the start and end of the beam effect. You can configure it like however you want, but for this tutorial I will first set these muzzle attachments up, and I will speed this part up. Tip attachment is basically tip of the gun, so this should be easy to adjust. Next is this shell eject point, which is the revolving part of the gun for this one. This bolt motor is a rigged part and it's the best if you create this while making the gun. You just set these attachments depending on the bolt movement. Once you are done, the basic part will be finished. There are more possible attachments for different gun types which I will mention at the end of the video, but I'm only showing a pistol in this video. These sounds can also be configured if you want, of course. I will move this pistol back to the starter gear folder. There are a lot of configurations in these folders. All of these are optional, and they have default values. However, it's good to have them. I will just change ammo and damage here, but I will also mention these later again at the end of the video. Not all possible configuration values are here, so the Developer Hub page is helpful here. The next thing we need to do is adding this tag to the weapon. The required plugin for this is Tag Editor. Do not download any fake copies. I will link it in the description. If you are using the Roblox version of this, there should be an option to import this tag. However, this is the version I forked, and I already have that set in this, so I will just tag it. Before testing this gun, I need to mention some more configurations for this kit. As you could see, there were some configurations mentioning some effects or hit marks. These animations, casings, hit marks and all of the stuff seen here can have some custom additions, and you can also use them with the configuration values after adding them. I didn't prepare proper holding animations for this revolver, so mine will look a bit weird, but if you are using this for a game then you should probably prepare some as well. There are also some different projectiles and UI customization options available here. You should also check these out yourself. This next part pretty much applies to every single gear you create. You need to set its tool grip either with the plugin or with these properties. I find the plugin easier. I will also link this in the description. This is pretty easy to use. You just move this attachment and make sure that gun looks right in this character's hand. This takes some time, so I will just speed this up as well. There's some weird thing about this kit, and that is, the tool I positioned right looks like it's pointing up. This has an easy fix. Just position your tool and move it 90 degrees to down. So I will quickly do that right now. So if we test it now, it looks proper like this. Ignore the holding animation. As I said, it's because I didn't set the animations up for this gun. As you can hear and see, this gun can shoot and has the shooting sound of the pistol because I didn't change that. You can add all your custom guns like this. Honestly, Roblox has done a great job with this kit. I will move on to the last part right now. So Roblox has a whole page in Developer Hub about this. All of the possible configurations for different types of guns are here. I only showed the pistol in this video, because showing all of these will really take a long time. Here in this page, you can find explanations about all of the naming rules, attachment positioning and also all these configurations. These parts mention about the last ones I showed in a detail, and the last part is about the GUI. You should definitely check this page out before starting to create your own guns. That was it for this video. Hope you understood. See you in another one.